Hey guys, thanks for watching the channel. This is Ken Marlin, the Windows Champ, and I'm going to take you right through what is Windows 10 IoT Enterprise LTSC 2019. Get this question quite a bit. It's a difficult product to find information on. The IoT channel is a specific channel of Windows products, not just Windows 10, but some other Windows products as well, that are used specifically for appliances, as you see here in this photo, from a robot arm to a gaming casino, ATM machines, cash registers, digital signage, medical equipment, and so on from various many different industries. And as you can see on this slide here, as we cover all the different verticals, what happens is sometimes in these companies, when they go to build an appliance, a lot of times they'll stick with Windows 10 Professional, not even realizing that there is an IoT embedded channel specifically dedicated for appliances. And you absolutely, if you're building any kind of appliance whatsoever, are going to want to use the IoT embedded channel and not use the Pro. Specifically, the Pro falls under the SAC or semi-annual servicing channel, which forces new features on you, has a very short life cycle. You're going to want to absolutely move to the long-term service channel. And you can do that by getting in touch with us at Arrow, and we can take you through the steps needed very quickly to get you off the ground testing for basically no cost. We can get you going, get you testing, and you actually won't have to buy or pay for a license until ready to ship a production unit. So if you're thinking about testing the product, there's no cost involved, get with us. Now, what is Windows 10 IoT Enterprise LTSC 2019? It is full-blown Windows 10 Enterprise. The word IoT won't actually be in the product anywhere. That's the channel that the product falls in, but it is Windows 10, full Windows 10 Enterprise, and then it's the long-term service channel. So it is locked into a build version. Build, in this case, build 1809, which is the year and month, September of 2018, that it launched, but they still call it the 2019 edition, and you will get 10 years of support. You actually get 10 years of life, 10 years of support, perfect for your appliance. Lock it into that part number, it'll always be available. Lock into that Windows 10 build, nothing new comes along to break it. The product is licensed based on the physical processor with 3 honor system choices. That means there's only one product, but 3 honor system ways to license it. So it's going to run on any x86 processor, but if you happen to be using an Intel Atom, you can get the entry. If you happen to be using an i7, you've got to go with the high end, and then there's a value, an i3, i5 in the middle. There's a specific processor chart that you'll want to look at because of all the different models of processors, but you ultimately choose the correct part number and COA sticker license to put on your device based on the processor. And the pricing is based on those 3 choices, with a very entry-level price, a middle price, and a high price. And you would get with us here at Arrow, and we can quote those to you, give you an idea of what that pricing is. We can't put that here on this on the video, but certainly get with us. We'll give you a quote. You can get that in 1, 10, and 100 packs. And again, you won't have to buy these COA sticker licenses until you're ready to ship a production. But the thing to remember is these. The COA sticker is the license. So not the product key, not the activation. Those just enable it when you're ready to actually make the device legal and licensed legally. You then procure a sticker to put on that device. Now, there's 2 types of stickers you can buy. Most of our OEM customers go with the first choice, which is the first 3 part numbers there. Again, high value and entry, but it's the EPKEA single key, which stands for embedded product key entry activation. It uses a single key that you just put in your image, and then you never have to deal with keys again. And it uses a tiny sticker on the right there that's more gold yellow. And that number that's on the sticker is not a key code. That's a serial number. There's no key code on the sticker. It's a much smaller thumbnail sticker. You put the key code in your image, never have to deal with keys again. It's fantastic, super for building appliances. Blast the image onto the device and then activate it. And this product actually has an optional deferred activation process too. So if you're building something that's not going to be on the internet and you don't want to have to deal with activation, this product can do that as well. Get with me for more details on that. Then you have the other option. If you want the key code on the sticker, there is that option there, the bottom 3 part numbers, they call that PKEA. And every single sticker will have a new key on it, just like the example in the lower right. You will have to change that key on every system you load and activate it. But some customers want the key on the sticker. Again, most of our customers go with the single key, no key on sticker. The reason, again, you'll want this product, 10 years of life, 10 years of support, and no new features to come along, although you still can get security updates if desired, but ultimately you can fully disable Windows Update. So with this brand new 2019 based on 1809, they actually improved the assigned access. So if you're building a kiosk or any type of device that you want to have different user experiences, they've improved that. They've also improved a number of other things that are on the slide around locking the product down and making it secure and making it into an appliance so you can control that user experience. So much more improved features over the 2016 edition. A quick look at the roadmap specifically for the long-term service channel. It used to be called LTSB, which is long-term service branch, and now it's called long-term service channel. There are only three editions. 2015 that is launched on the original build back in July of 2015. Then in the middle, the long-term LTSB 2016 edition based on build 1607. It came out in July of 2016. And then now we have the current version LTSC 2019 based on build 1809, which is also codenamed Redstone 5 release. So then you have at the bottom there, you do have the codenamed Redstone 1 through Redstone 5 with the build versions there. And you can see that the latest 1809 2019 is Redstone 5. If we look at the actual servicing and support of the product, you have the three editions there with the 2019 on the bottom. Threw in all the dates for you. So not only do you have the date of when the product started and when it will go end of life on the far right, January 2029, you also have the support. So included the support. So sorry, end of life, bottom left hand corner, big dates there, end of life. The other dates here are the end of support. That way, when you're building a device, you can plan for this. You know how long it's going to be available, how long it'll be supported, and this makes it super easy for you guys. I'll wrap things up. Thank you for watching the video. Check out my blog at our Arrow Microsoft page. Also have the end of life dates there for all other embedded products. Get started, send us an email, msembedded@arrow.com, and we can get you going on the agreement that's required and get you the product, media, key code. You can start testing, no cost. Give us a shout out. Thanks for watching the video.